Thanks for staying curious. You're watching Smithsonian Science How Behind the Scenes with Smithsonian geologist Ben Andrews.
Hi, my name is Ben Andrews, and I'm a scientist with the Smithsonian Institution National Museum of Natural History. I'm here today to talk with you about the three types of rocks that cover the Earth's surface. Those types of rocks are igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. We're going to begin here by looking at a few igneous rocks. All igneous rocks begin as molten rock or magma, and sometimes they don't crystallize at all. When there's no crystals formed, we get a rock like an obsidian right here, which at this time is just a big piece of glass. Now, if we let bubbles form in that rock, we could get a pumice, like this white rock here. This pumice is entirely glass, but it also has about 75% bubbles in it. Now, if we let a rock crystallize all the way, we can get a rock like a granite right here. The difference between this granite, this pumice, and this obsidian has nothing to do with composition, but has everything to do with whether there are crystals and whether there are bubbles. If a magma crystallizes below the surface as an intrusive rock, we get a granite, whereas if it erupts as a lava, we can get an obsidian, or if it explodes, we can get a pumice. Now, the other type of igneous rock we have up here are basalt lava and pumice. We see that right here with the Pahoehoe lava, and right here with a couple of pieces of basalt pumice, or basalt scoria. Our next type of rock is a sedimentary rock. And we have that right here with this beautiful laminated sandstone. Now, sedimentary rocks can ultimately be made in a couple different ways. One way is through the layer-by-layer deposition of pieces of other rocks, and that's what we have here. There's about 40 or 50 different layers of sand in this sandstone, and each one of those is made up of little tiny pieces of sand or of other rock. The other way that we can form sedimentary rocks is through the chemical precipitation of things like a limestone. And often in sedimentary rocks, we also find fossils. Our last type of rock today are metamorphic rocks. And on the end of the table here, we have a gneiss that's spelled G-N-E-I-S-S. And this is a rock that's been totally recrystallized. So it did not melt, but it was taken to such extreme pressures and temperatures that all of the individual minerals and bits and pieces of this rock reformed into new mineral grains. And we can also see that this rock has some amazing folding in it. That's because most metamorphic rocks are getting squished and smushed as well as cooked. And that's why we have that amazing series of folds and wiggly, squiggly lines there. Thank you very much.